Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and on today's video, we're back in Eastern Oregon. We're gonna go gold mining back here underground in this old abandoned gold mine. So in a previous video, we were in here, we were taking some samples, and we found a really, really hot spot, really, really high grade gold. It's averaging 5 to 10 ounces. We got one assay that was over 20 ounces a ton, I think. So we're back, and today our goal is to go down that hole there, back to our high grade area. And I'm gonna knock down as much of that high grade as I can onto a tarp, get it bagged up, bring it back to the shop, and run it through the system. So let's go check out what we're gonna be working on today and see how much we can get. All right, here's our first little obstacle. We gotta go down this ladder down to the second level here. It's about, I don't know, 15 feet or so. So we'll get down here onto the lower level. And it looks like there was just a heck of a rain event here not too long ago, because there's a bunch of stuff that's all washed down here. So there's a bunch of water running down these, creating little gullies, and all this organic matter and junk washed in here. And then here, right above us, if you look straight up, oh, there's daylight. So that's where the old miners went to the surface. And we're going to be working up here today. I'll put a link for a card or whatever up in the corner if you want to check out our first video where we took these samples. But we're going to be working right up here. This was the really, really rich spot. And I've been looking and thinking about this since we were in here. And I don't know if it's going to show up very well, but there's the vein. It's striking more or less east-west. And then I don't know if you're going to be able to see this, but I'll try and show you. Up here on the wall, right there, running down that way, is a fault. And it kind of offsets the vein right here. But there's where the vein comes back. And then there's a little hole up to the first level. And that's where we're going to be working. Now, I pointed out that offset fault right in there, because oftentimes, and more what I'm finding is where a vein and a fault intersect, or two veins intersect like that, it becomes very, very rich. And I don't know if that's where the original mineral fluids came up and then they squirted off in this vein, or if there was something happening there. But typically, when these veins are forming, if you get a change in pressure, temperature, or chemistry, oftentimes the minerals will fall out at that location. And what better place to do that than the intersection of the fault? You can see there's some copper staining here. The owners told me that the copper staining is a really good indication of high grade. He's done a bunch of slab work on this stuff. Up here you can see there's very little copper staining. It's pretty much isolated to this side, the footwall side of the vein. And the vein here is probably about 12 to 16 inches wide across there. And it's really nice because I got this big overhang I can work all the way up. I've got a little roto hammer chisel thing. I've got my hammer and chisel. I got a bunch of fun stuff we're going to use today. But I'm going to lay out a tarp down here. And I'm just going to start wailing away on that thing and see how much we can get. Well, I'm disturbing all kinds of wildlife in here. There's a bat flying around. Let's see if it'll come back again. And then there's a pack rat sitting right there in that stall. There's bats in here. I've got all sorts of tools here today. Got that battery-powered roto hammer. I think what I'm going to These first, though, is just a good old hammer and chisel. See how much I can knock off of there easily. I'll get worn out pretty quick on that, I'm sure, but give it a shot, see what I can knock off of there. I'm going to be wearing a respirator for the quartz dust, and there's a bunch of pack rat, we'll call it poop, for the video down here, so I don't want to be breathing a whole bunch of that stuff. So I'll be all PPE'd up, and we'll see what we get. We're about 30 seconds into it here, and I've already found a huge piece of gold right there. And I should have got it in the face when it was sticking in the face, but I was so excited to get it out and show you guys. But that's a pretty dang nice piece of gold there. And then looking up here at the face, let's see if I can get this. There's kind of gold sprinkled all through it. There's a piece. There's some more up here. Right up here. I can't see the camera, so I hope I'm getting it here. But it looks like there's a little swath right here to here that's just loaded with gold, and I'm in the copper area where the owner told me to go. So I'm just gonna start working right in here, and there might be a little bit more up in here too, a bunch of galena, maybe that gray galena. But yeah, that's really, really nice looking stuff. Holy smokes. All right, well, I like the hammer and chisel just because it's a little more delicate and allow me to, like, I'm gonna try and pry this piece out right here. I want to save a bunch of these specimens for the owner. He's coming a little bit later today. But let me work with that hammer and chisel a little bit more and see if we can find some more specimens. Well, I better get some on video here before I hand cob all this out of here. Right up in here, see the gray? I think that's galena. I'm finding it right along with that galena. Here's kind of that first strip we were talking about where I saw it all at the beginning. I don't see a whole lot here right now. There might be some right up in there. I don't know if you can see it right there and there maybe. But it's breaking up really nice and easy. I'm spending more time looking at it than I am hitting on it. But after, I don't know, 5, maybe 10 minutes, I probably got 50 pounds in the ground. I want to work on this big knob here so I can work it all the way back. There's some really good looking stuff back over here, but I don't want to be under there hitting. And this is all kind of ravelly ground in here, and all these big knockers, I don't want anything to come down on my head, especially as I open up this hole bigger. I don't know what's going to happen. So I'm just going to be careful and just kind of not work with anything over my head. The ground up above looks really good and competent. So I'm just going to work this back a little bit. But there's some really, really good stuff in here. I hope we get a bunch of gold when we run the equipment. Well, I've got quite a bit of vein knocked out of there now, and I'm going to work on getting this big doniger right here out of there. I don't like that over my head. So I've got, this is the second tarp full. I'm going to put this in sacks. But a lot of nice looking stuff in there. I've got a couple pieces of some nice gold on them. The tarp's working really well. I can just kind of get it all into a nice little pile, get it up. I probably got 75 pounds there. So I'll get this cleaned up, put into a couple sacks, and then we'll come back. I'll knock a bunch of that waste off of there and just put it on the ground. Then I can keep going on that vein. That'll open up that vein a little bit more for me. Everything down has to come up. It all comes up this ladder. One sack at a time. Well, I got a little ladder in my spot here so I can get up and chisel down from the top. And man, that is making a huge difference. Look at the pile of muck I got here. It took me about 15 minutes. I probably got 4 or 5 sacks there. And I really got a big old chunk out from the upper section of the vein there. And there's a level above me. And I think what happened is when they were going through and putting in this level above me, their blasts shattered the quartz down about a foot into the foot, not the foot wall, but the floor of that upper level. And so it made it all real loose and it was super easy chipping. But now I've got this big knob here that is real hard. And I've got this little bottom of a round here in the foot wall. I think I may try and take out some of that foot wall, and then I've got somewhere I can slab this hard vein into. But I'm going to get all this muck off the floor first and get it bagged up and then see about getting the rest of that big chunk of vein out of there. It's good looking stuff. The vein's really pinching fast up here. It's only about, I don't know, 8 inches wide up there. And as you can see underneath, it pinches down. So once we get this big chunk out of here, we'll see what the vein's doing and what it looks like. Also, up there, I'm kind of running out of mineralization. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. Well, I dug a little bit around the footwall, that vein. It goes back in there maybe 8 or 10 inches. And I really don't like to be picking on the walls much because there's a big slab up there that worked its way down, and all this is just kind of hanging here. But it's on the foot wall. I'm not too terribly worried about it. So I'm going to work on this chunk. If it was up on the hanging wall, you know, and hanging over your head like that, that big slab, that's no good. But now I can try and just kind of slab that big chunk into that hole that I made. I got my tarp cleaned up. We got 8 bags of muck out of that. And, that ends up being about 400 pounds. That hole up there that I made is roughly 1.5 feet deep, 2 feet long, and about 1 foot wide or so. And so I think for 400 pounds, I think that's about 3 3.25 cubic feet. So we're right around 125 pounds of cubic feet, which I think about what quartz weighs. So anyway, that was kind of an interesting little calculation, but let's get going on this big chunk and see what we can get out of it. Well, it's still pretty hard. I've knocked a little bit off of there, but I'm going to try one of these feathering wedges, and there's kind of a natural little seam there. Dan Hurd introduced me to these. Thanks, Dan. He gave me a few as well. So I'm going to try and drill a hole right in here somewhere and put that wedge in like that and see if I can wedge this just big old knob off this wall. So I'll show you after I get the hole drilled and see if I can video as I hammer that thing down. All right, I got her in there. Let's see if I can do all this at the same time. I'm kind of perched on the ladder over a hole sideways in a... Anyway, let's see if this works. Oh, it broke something up. Let me get my hammer drill and chisel away what I broke up there and take a look. Maybe I should have tried to wedge it off that crack. All right, let's try it this way. Well, something happened there. That was pretty good. I'll do that again. Thank you, Dan. I got my chisel right in the hole. And it's coming. There it goes. Nice. Well, there's our vein. Got that big old knob knocked off of there. Got a big old pile of muck here. I got a bag up. And I don't know how many bags I got, but I think I can carry about 20 or so back with me. I got my little pickup today, so I don't want to do a whole lot more work and have bags that I can't take with me. So I'm going to get this bagged up, and we'll take inventory of how much muck we got. All right, guys. There's all 18 sacks in the back of the truck. Every single one of those had to come up that ladder, through the underground workings, up the ladder, and then across to the truck. And man, oh man, am I tired. But we're all loaded up, so I'm going to head home. Be sure to subscribe so you can check out part two when I process all this stuff through our equipment. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.